So we've talked about visual cues to encode and represent your data. Another thing to consider is the different types of data that are available. Most data can be categorized into three basic types. In fact, we've seen all three types of this data during our walkthrough of the baseball data without explicitly referring to them as such. The first of these types is numeric data. Numeric data, as you might expect, is any data where our data points are exact numbers. These data have meaning as a measurement, such as a baseball player's height or weight, or as a count, such as the number of hits or home runs for a player, or how many players there were on a team. Statisticians also might call numerical data quantitative data. Numerical data can be characterized into discrete or continuous data. Discrete data has distinct values, whereas continuous data can assume any value within a range. For example, a player's number of home runs would be a discrete data set. You can only have discrete whole number values like 10, 25, or 34. A player cannot, for example, hit 14.375 home runs. A player either hits a home run or he doesn't. On the other hand, continuous data are numbers that can fall anywhere within a range, like a player's batting average, which falls between 0 and 1,000. So a player could have a batting average of 0.250, they could also have a batting average of 357 or 511. And so again, just to hammer this home, examples of numeric data might be a baseball player's height or weight, or their number of home runs, or number of hits, or number of doubles. The takeaway here is that this is data that are numbers, and they are not ordered in time. They're just numbers that we've collected.